Hours before the attempted assassination, Thomas Crooks begins his day scoping out the rally site, sources tell CNN. He arrives mid-morning and stays for 70 minutes, then drives more than an hour back home where he picks up an AR-type rifle. His father later tells authorities he thought Crooks was going to the shooting range. Crooks buys ammunition at a local gun shop and travels back to the rally site. 5:10 p.m., local police first spot Crooks. Around the same time, he's seen in this video obtained by CNN affiliate WTAE, walking outside the perimeter of the rally in front of a building he would later climb. At 5:33 p.m., the motorcade for former President Donald Trump arrives as the eager crowd awaits. About 15 minutes later, Pennsylvania State Police notify the Secret Service of a suspicious person and share a photo of Crooks. Countersnipers are alerted, according to a congressional briefing by law enforcement. But officers lose sight of him. Moments before Trump walks out, countersnipers can be seen facing opposite directions. Trump takes the stage at 6:02 p.m. His team was not informed of the suspicious sighting. 2 minutes before the first shot, the countersniper on the building closest to the shooter's location adjusts his position. On the ground outside the perimeter, people start reacting to movement on the roof of a nearby building.
Look, they're all pointing.
A uniformed officer can be seen walking toward the building.
Yeah, someone's on top of the roof. Look. There he is right there. Right there, see him? He's laying down.
About 10 seconds later, a separate countersniper team on the southern building turns around 180 degrees to face the shooter's building. On the ground, people alert law enforcement.
Officer,
people in our country that shouldn't be here. Dangerous people.
Criminals.
We have criminals.
He's we on have the roof. He's right here.
We have people that
right
should
here.
Not be here.
Right on the roof.
Seconds later, another video shows an officer walking backwards, apparently looking up. A man approaches and points to the shooter's location. The officer turns and walks out of frame. At the same time, two counter-sniper teams are captured in these photos, aiming in the direction of the shooter.
Crazy.
Realizing the danger, the crowd outside the perimeter starts rushing away. On the other side of the field, a counter-sniper can be seen peering through his scope at the direction of the building where the shooter is.
What happened?
Shots are fired at 6:11 p.m. Trump is injured. The gunman is taken out seconds later. On his body, law enforcement find a remote transmitter to detonate explosives that were later discovered in his car, along with a drone, a tactical vest, and more ammo.
Investigators also found the shooter's cell phone on his body. It had a screenshot of the live stream of the rally. It was taken 10 minutes before the shooting. And the search history of the cell phone showed that he had looked up articles about prominent U.S. politicians, both Democrats and Republicans. Kyung Lah, CNN, Bethel Park, Pennsylvania.